Hey guys, Jobwise Jones again. Today I'm talking to you once again from my vehicle. The reason why, this is where I take my breaks from the job. I don't record on the job, I take my breaks away from the job. So anyway, today is a good video for you, I think, because I got an email first. My subscriber was asking me for a phone call, so she called me and we discussed for about 20 minutes. She has a real fear that she's currently experiencing right now. And the fear is that she has an issue with her direct supervisor and she wants to go above his head. And she's worried about that. She's even wondering, is it okay to do that? So I've been doing this for many years, you guys. So the issue here is that the employee is scared. Worried, basically, if she goes above her supervisor's head to report something pretty serious, according to our phone call. So, the short answer is yes, you can go above your direct reports, a direct supervisor's head, of course. You can do that. This day and age, companies welcome that more than they don't welcome that, because it makes the managers and above them even aware what's really going on the ground, right? You got to think of a company like the military does. You know, the employees are like the frontline troops, you know. Your supervisors are like the sergeants who watch things going on, you know. Your managers are probably like the younger lieutenants and so on and so forth. So the further you are away from the front line, the less you really know. For me, I've had in my career, I've had anywhere from 100 to 245 employees under me. There's no way I can possibly keep track of that many people. So that's why you have supervisors who do that work for you, who keep a closer contact with those employees, right? So yes, you can do that. So the first thing is this, Lisa. You want to understand that, make sure that the situation you are talking about is warranted to go above their head, meaning that Is it a huge issue, right? You must feel the way that it's such a big issue, you need to report this above their head. Because that's the first thing they're going to ask you, the person above your supervisor, is did you talk it over with them? Now, you don't have to, of course. I said that already. But they will ask that first question, did you report it to the immediate supervisor? If no, you go and explain why. That's a big issue. Number two is this. If you feel comfortable going to the second person above their head, you want to either go there in person, or you want to go there, or you want to do a phone call. Now, I always say this. Here's the rule for this. If you want to go above their head, you want to first do a phone call or email asking for the manager to spend maybe 15 or 30 minutes with you to discuss a personal issue. Now, do not write down the issue on anywhere on your desk where someone can see it. Never do that. You want to send an email to the manager asking them and put, and just abbreviate it. Maybe the supervisor is, just say, they're giving you a hard time about your religion, right? Just say, can I talk to you? And put in brackets, religion. Period. And send it off. Then wait for them to respond to you in 48 hours. That's 2 days. A response back from you saying yes, they had no problem talking to you about this subject, and they should also have the date and time for you to go talk to them. Number two. Number three, when you go to the manager to talk about your supervisor, you don't want to make it so much as a blaming game as much as just a facts. You know, on this date here, I experienced this, and this is what happened. The way you can support that is to have documentation of those times when it happened. Yeah. It is a he said, she said, if there's no witnesses there, right? Because you could say, so-and-so did this to me, my supervisor, and the supervisor can say no, but you at the same time also want to make it so that you have documented this situation enough to cover yourself. How do you document? You document via email to yourself. When these events occur, you want to make sure you put this down, that this occurred at this date, and send the email to yourself so you have this stuff awesomely documented, because when you send emails, as you know already, there's a date stamp, there's also a time stamp, so therefore it's proof, at least for you, that you have covered yourself in this situation. Another thing too, you guys, a lot of people think, oh, they're going to be fired, you know, I'll have their job or whatever. No, typically when someone who you report to makes a mistake, right? Say it's not harassment. Say it's just honest mistakes they're making every day, right? Typically, that tells the manager that this person isn't bad, maybe. Maybe they just need some education. Like if your supervisor keeps making paperwork errors or keeps messing up your vacation times or keeps messing up your hours that you work, because hours are very important, right? Hours are how you get paid, you know? So maybe 2 months of this stuff is like, oh my gosh, I've had enough of this stuff. You know, I got to talk to this person's manager to fix this. So typically a manager like myself, for instance, I'm not going to get angry at my supervisor, but I'm going to tell them, what do you think you're doing wrong here? They'll tell you, oh, maybe I've been doing this part wrong with the time clock, or maybe I'm not recording their punching right, you know. Whatever it is, it will make then the supervisor aware of their downfall, their deficiency in their job, because it's making then their employee at risk for their pay, because maybe they're getting their pay shortened, you know. So that's a big issue. Number four, when you finally have that meeting with the manager who's your supervisor's boss, just be calm and cool and factual. You know, the thing I always say is calm heads prevail. So if you go there with an accusatory, raising your voice, pointing fingers at your supervisor, you're not going to get very far. You have to go there with a concern so serious you needed to talk to the manager. And since you're there now, take advantage of that time, you know, speak in a measured voice, show your evidence, understand to the manager how it impacts your life. Make that such a big deal, because every manager wants productive employees, because a productive employee makes the company look good. It also makes sure the company gets paid every month, right? So it is in the manager's best interest to at least try to keep their employees somewhat happy. Gleeful and excited? Well, probably not, but someone happy to make them want to come to work every day, right? That's your goal. So the manager will listen to you. The manager should listen to you, because that you might have that one issue, but you might be speaking for 14 or 15 or 50 people, but you're the only one who had the gumption to go talk to the supervisor's boss to fix this, correct? That's a big deal. Another thing too, after your conversation with the manager, thank him or her, and then you go on about your way, but you don't say a word to anyone. Do not get into the gossip game. You keep that to yourself, because you are a mature adult and you know how to handle that situation by keeping your mouth shut. But once you get back to your desk, you send another timestamp email. So what does that mean? That means you want to send an email to the manager thanking him or her for their time, because that again closes the end part of it. It closes up the conversation. You're done. Boom. You sent out an email timestamp that says you had that conversation. It's proof that you've had a conversation. That's what you want at all times. Always end that with an email. At this point, you guys, I want to ask you for a please to subscribe to this channel. It's growing. I'm trying very hard to cover some really great topics, and I would appreciate some support. Thank you very much for that. Also, please hit the like button. Send me some comments, too, about your situations of not being happy on the job and having to report above your supervisor. I really want to hear that. I really do. So let's get back into our topic here. Here's a huge issue these days. You guys know sometimes some workplaces are very, shall we say, they're getting violent, right? So, retaliation. At some point, your supervisor is going to be called into the office by his or her boss. No supervisor really wants to deal with that, because it's their boss, right? At no point, at any time, is retaliation allowed. So after the manager talks to your supervisor, he or she may bring up this topic enough times so that they'll understand that maybe this was you that reported me, right? The employee reported me, right? And not all supervisors can understand that it's a good for them to have been reported on, because it could be an educational situation for them. So most companies have retaliation no-nos in place. An employee, a supervisor, a manager, it doesn't matter who works at that company, they cannot retaliate against you. That is illegal. Those kind of things, if proven, are easily won in court, and every company knows that. No company wants to be on the front page of a paper showing that they did anything retaliatory because someone told on the company or told on a supervisor. No company wants that. So again, you guys can report above you. They always prefer you go through the chain of command, but not everybody can go through their chain of command because not every chain of command is trustworthy. Not every chain in that command is trustworthy. Also too, sometimes you guys as managers, you know, I get it sometimes. The occasional employee just wants to talk to me instead of the supervisor. And it's not for anything they want to report on. They just might feel comfortable with me or another supervisor or assistant manager or whatever. So, you know, those things happen too. But if you guys want to have that serious conversation with your supervisor's manager, have the documentation with you guys via your emails. Make sure you talk in a calm, measured voice. State your facts. You know, don't blame, don't finger point, don't shout, don't get loud. Just talk calmly so the manager can understand what you're talking about. Last thing here is retaliation. There is no room for retaliation. If that happens to you, once again, you record those events. Now, the reason why I'm telling you guys to record everything via email, write these things down via email, is because if the company itself doesn't help you, say 3 or 4 months go by, it doesn't help you. If you ever feel a need to go to an outside source, meaning a legal outside source, you will have the documentation there with you when these things happen, who you talk to, what happened during the conversation, and how you sent the email that showed you had the conversation. And that at that point became the job of the management to find you some kind of resolution to this problem. So keep those records. But you know, you really, most times you won't have to go outside to another company, to a legal entity to solve your problem. Typically, these things are solved in-house because no manager wants to know about the supervisor not helping out their employee. Most managers understand that happy employees make the workplace work. Understand? We're very aware of this. So that's how you do it. So Lisa, I want to tell you through this video, you want to start documenting when these things have been happening, okay? And then yes, you want to go to the manager of that supervisor, that's fine. Keep your voice measured, eye-to-eye contact, just the facts, please. End up with it, go back to your desk, email the manager a thank you note, and keep your notes, and then make sure nothing against you is being retaliated. Okay, guys, that's the whole video there. It's kind of a serious topic, I know. Please email me your stories. I want to hear your stories. Also, please comment, share your stories about these kind of things. If you ever had where you had to go above your supervisor, above your manager, tell me how far you had to go. And was the problem resolved? Help everybody out on this channel. Tell us what happened to you so we can all leave the notes and say, oh my gosh, this is crazy, you know, or, oh, that's a pretty good resolution. They took care of that problem. That's a pretty good company, you know, and whatever you want to say, just let me know, okay? Hit that like, subscribe, hit the bell, of course, for more more YouTube videos. And also, most importantly, subscribe. I would appreciate it. Thank you very much. Jobwise Jones. Goodbye.